Hi, hello, namaste, salam alaikum. I have to bring in other worldly greetings to these videos. At some point I'm gonna have like 20 at the start where I just have like rattle off a list, have like a Rolodex of different ways to say hello or how to greet people in other countries. That'd be fun. Anyways, something very interesting came across my desk this morning. Apparently, according to this dude on Twitter, he was banned for abusing exploits inside of TF2. In this particular case, he was abusing an out-of-bounds exploit where he was playing engineer and built sentries outside of the map. Whether or not this is actually true, no idea. Probably not, based off his most recent tweet, heavily implying that he was likely doing something he shouldn't have been doing. Don't know what that is. And also, Valve has never banned players for abusing glitches and exploits in the past. At least, I don't think they have. I've never come across a case of them doing this, and I find it rather odd that they would start doing this now. But, as a thought exercise, let's assume that this guy was indeed banned for abusing an in-game exploit. Should this guy have received a permaban for abusing an in-game exploit or a glitch? And I think this begs the broader question for games in general, should players ever be permanently banned for abusing glitches and exploits? In my opinion, no. With really big W-I-T-H, with some exceptions. No, with some exceptions, which I will say for the end. In my opinion, the line has to be drawn somewhere, so let's contemplate what that line should be. While in general, I do think someone abusing glitches or map exploits can be very annoying and disruptive, depending on what they're doing, mind you, it's by no means equivalent to something like cheating or hosting bots. A permaban for this specific case is, in my opinion, really ridiculous. If this ban was really for an out-of-bounds exploit, something that's been happening for essentially as long as I can remember, for well over a decade, I think that demonstrates a crazy paradigm shift, a crazy disconnect away from how TF2 is being treated now and how it was being treated in the past. Because in the past, gameplay-related exploits were never treated as the player's fault. I believe this should hold true for any video game. It's the developer's fault, the game's fault. Players were simply playing with what's been handed to them. It's like handing a child a firecracker and a lighter and then wagging your finger at them. No, 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 little Billy, now, now, don't play with that even though we handed it directly to your hands. Don't do it. Of course the players are going to mess with what's given to them, and if the exploit or glitch isn't meant to be in the game, then the developers should remove it, not remove the player fucking around with it. Glitches and exploits can be disruptive, yes. But they're by no means comparable to injecting cheats or doing some other means of breaking the game like a DDoS attack, which is illegal. Banning exploiters isn't even an effective solution to this problem, because the problem will persist, available to everyone, until the developers fix it. Not to mention, TF2 is a casual game anyways, so there's no real need for these symbolic bans to dissuade people from fucking around and experimenting with busted game assets or glitches. I suppose modern games are more sensitive to these types of things because it's seen as disruptive to prevent players from leveling up their meaningless competitive rank or so they can't get their next loot box or cosmetic in their battle pass's progression tree. Now, by the reasoning I've just posted, I can already see the slippery slope forming in the comments. Well, if TF2 is a casual game where winning doesn't matter, why not just let people cheat or do whatever the hell they want? Well, that's why we have rules. This is why we draw the line somewhere. Somewhere in the sand, we put a line saying this is allowed and this is not. And that line, in my opinion, is that it's okay to play with what's been shipped with the game. If you're injecting cheats or incorporating some third-party means to be disruptive, take a toaster bath. This goes back to what I said a moment ago, that these are not equivalent actions. One is playing with the game as is, and another is going out of your way to be as disruptive as possible by intentionally breaking the game, likely because you were abused as a child. In fact, this opens up the floodgates in the opposite direction. Let's analyze this as a spectrum, mind you. Griefing is considered disruptive to gameplay, so should we ban engineers that build teleporters near a ledge and cause players to fall off for a laugh? Friendly players are considered disruptive by some because they're not actively contributing towards the game and are negatively impacting a player's chances of winning. Should these people be banned? Should players be banned because they're not playing an ideal class that benefits their team? In these cases, obviously not, because TF2 isn't meant to be taken that seriously. Whereas in other games, like Overwatch, playing suboptimally in the eyes of your team is a bannable offense, which is fucking wild. And then this continues down a similar vein. Should people have been banned for using the infinite health exploit with the gloves of running urgently? Should people have been banned for using the infinite jump exploit as the scout? The infinite range exploit with Pyro's flamethrowers? Should all of the players who opened cases during the 100% unusual exploit have been permanently banned? The line for TF2 has been drawn for years. Exploiting something that has been shipped with the game, accessible to all players, entirely at the fault of the developer, is not a bannable offense. It's the dev's fault, not the players. This is not me supporting the abuse of glitches and exploits. These things should not happen, but players should not be permanently banned for using these things either. Now, when it comes to glitches and exploits that can be abused for, say, profit, like item duplication, that's grounds for a ban, in my opinion. Especially when the exploit is kept secret by the people who are abusing it for a profit. That's morally wrong, and honestly, that deserves a permaban. What's also morally wrong, in my opinion, is broadcasting an exploit to a wider audience for a profit. Not simply abusing it for show, but walking people through how it's done and then throwing it on a YouTube channel. That's intentionally opening up the floodgates to widespread disruption, which, in my opinion, is really fucked up. I think that's all I wanted to say, so let me know what you guys think. Should players be permanently banned for exploits and glitches? Curious to see what you guys have to say. That's it. See ya.